just because we get around.
Talking about my generation.
This ain't do look awful.
Talking about my generation.
That was something that the NCAA mandated. Essentially what they found was that the Native American imagery, Indians, were considered hostile and abusive. And began to ban teams from postseason play, or at least ban the mascot from being a part of that. And there are a number of universities across the country that have Indian imagery as their mascot, and the NCAA was really cracking down on it. Several universities decided to fight that. For instance, Florida State, the Seminoles, they were able to pay the Seminole tribe for the rights to remain the Seminoles. Whereas others who had more of a generic name, like the Indians, spent millions of dollars and never got to court. So our board of trustees and our administrators decided that this was a battle that we could not fight and win without spending millions of dollars and still not have an opportunity to win. So ultimately, the school decided it was time to make a change after 77 years. Fortunately, we kind of knew that something might have to happen. And so years before, we began to go away from the Indian imagery into the Block A State logo that we have. So a lot of our uniforms, a lot of our signs had that Block A State. Now, we did have to go around, and it took months of searching to find all the Indian imagery that we had. And unfortunately, the NCAA said you have to change, but we're not going to help you pay to make that change. It was difficult to find all of the items, that whether it was a sign at the football stadium or the floors in our weight rooms and what have you, to find everything that had Indians on it. But we also had to change our letterhead, you know, go from Indian imagery to the Block A State logo, and then we also have our Red Wolf imagery that we had to, this was all Indian, and we had to change it. And so the price tag on that gets into the six figures real easy, real quick. What we did is we opened that up to anybody and everybody who wanted to submit a name, a suggestion, and it was mainly done over our website. And from there, more than 1,000 names was submitted. And we had different groups of people from trustees and alumni to Red Wolf Club members, or actually Indian Club members at the time, to lettermen, to spirit groups, to just fans. We ended up with about 12 groups that sat down and took that list and began to narrow it down to a top 10. And then we began to take those different top tens and combine those and kind of find the common theme, if you will. We actually came up with three options, the top three. We actually ended up with the Red Wolf, and then there was a Ridge Rider type symbol with a horse and that sort of thing, and then something to do with the trains. As you know, there's a great history with trains right out here at the university. There were several names thrown out, from Express to A-Train to some different things like that. Ultimately, what we did is we took those three and looked at the marketability of those three images, even hired a consulting firm out of New York to come in and draw up some designs and some things like that to see what might fit best for us. Ultimately, it came down to the fact that even years ago, when the NCAA first started talking about the need to change mascots away from the Indian imagery, the Red Wolves started surfacing even years prior to the change. And when it came down to it, a lot of people liked the Red Wolves because it does have kind of a Native American mystique to it. The fact that there were Red Wolves in this area many, many years ago. And looking at the marketability of that particular logo, it just rose to the top. That's challenging when you look at 77 years of history that was tied to the Indians and so many people who grew up as Indians, and so many people who came to this institution and graduated as Indians, it was really, really difficult to replace that. One of my favorite stories is our very first home football game after the name change. What I did is I took several members of my staff and people who could just kind of go around the stadium and just listen to what people were saying. And what we found was a couple of older guys who were diehard Indians who were determined that they were going to be the Indians and didn't want to hear anything about the Red Wolves or anything like that. And at the beginning of the game, they were cheering for the Indians. They were yelling, "Go Indians," even though we were the Red Wolves. And when they sang the fight song, they sang I-N-D-I-A-N-S and spelled out Indians instead of Red Wolves. And they were determined that they were not going to change. By midway through the first quarter, after we had scored a few points and the excitement began to build, it's funny how they began to change. And this is just an example of what happened across the entire stadium. But these two gentlemen began to howl. They began to cheer for the Red Wolves. And then we actually unveiled our mascot at halftime. And during that unveiling, they were on their feet cheering and generating some excitement from that. And I think that really is a good example of how people embraced the Red Wolves. Now, obviously, we're only a few years in. It's going to take a long, long time to build 77 years worth of history. But it's been exciting to see how people have embraced the new mascot. Our sales of new merchandise with the Red Wolves logos on it vaulted us into the top five in the country as far as logo sales are concerned. And that's something that a smaller school like ourselves is a huge accomplishment for us. So I think people have really, really embraced it, and it's been exciting.
So there's more of a positive effect with the mascot change than there is a negative.
Yeah, and I'll tell you another story that was a lot of fun too. Our very first football game was at Texas A&M at College Station. And Texas A&M had not lost a home opener in 51 years. And we went down there and ended up beating them in their home opener as the Red Wolves. And I was up in the stands with a lot of our fans at the time. And there were some comments that were made that, you know, the Indians may not have been able to win that, but the Red Wolves, and they pulled it off. And so that created some excitement, too. A big win. It was probably one of the biggest wins in our history as a football program. And so, again, it helped people tie in and embrace the new mascot. I mean, I think people really like the new logo. It's created a new mystique for us. And not only that, one of the good things about that is that there is a Red Wolf Society, Preservation Society in North Carolina, and the director of that society called me, wrote me, and thanked us for choosing the Red Wolves. The Red Wolves are an endangered animal, and they're working on preserving the Red Wolves, and so they really like the idea of our choosing that as a mascot. And since it is so unique, there's so much mystique behind it because it's one of a kind, and that has helped from our fans being able to embrace it, but also from a merchandise standpoint. People want to go out and get the new look. It's something new and exciting, and our fans have really bought in.
What we all trying to cause a big sensation. Just talking about my generation.